For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
What is happening in Haiti? Tens of thousands of Haitians have been on the streets since January to protest President Jovenel Moïse's moves to consolidate a dictatorship in the country. According to the 1987 constitution, Moïse's term in office was set to end on February 2021. However, enjoying the backing of the United States, the Organization of American States, the European Union, and the United Nations, Moïse has refused to leave office, arguing that his term ends in 2022. Moïse has attempted to justify his illegal usurpation of power by calling for presidential and legislative elections on September 19 this year, as well as a referendum to replace the current constitution, which was won through a hard-fought struggle in 1986. Prior to Moïse overstaying his term, his administration had already violated democratic order and rule of law in the country. Since January 2020, Moïse has been ruling by a presidential decree as the country's parliament, the National Assembly, has not been functioning. The mandates of all the deputies and two-thirds of the senators expired without the occurrence of legislative elections, which were scheduled for October 2019. These elections were postponed because of a wave of protests sparked by a fuel shortage crisis. The country with 11 million people has only 11 elected officials in office. The diverse opposition has charted up a plan to return to democratic order with the appointment of Supreme Court Judge Joseph Messina Jean-Louis as the interim president of the Caribbean country. 72-year-old Jean-Louis has been a member of the Court of Cassation since 2011. His transitional government should administer the country for the next 2 years and organize elections for the next government. Judiciary. Multiple judicial bodies in the country, such as the Superior Council of Judicial Power and the Association of Haitian Lawyers, numerous religious groups and institutions have condemned the disregard of the constitution. They have called on Moïse to resign and for the opposition's plan for transitional government to be adhered to. Supreme Court Judge Yewikil Dabrissel was detained as Moïse alleged that he was part of an alleged plot against the state and the president. There is a strike in the judiciary at present. Amidst the breakdown of democracy, activists denounce a sharp increase in violence. Haitians are being killed and kidnapped at a scale that has never been seen before. PNH, the Haitian National Police, have unleashed a violent attack on journalists and there have been assassinations and arbitrary arrests of opponents. The PNH has committed more than 10 massacres since last year, while illegal armed groups with ties to the government have committed even more. Thousands of innocent Haitian citizens have been murdered. The role of imperialism. The US government, the UN and Organization of American States expressed the support for Moïse to continue the government and hold elections in September. Moïse wants to hold elections in 2022 while his gangs are leading the country while bleeding out public sectors. The UN has led a 17-year-long military occupation, first through the United Nations Stabilization Mission in Haiti and later the United Nations Mission for Justice Support in Haiti. This has been a central factor in aggravating the social, economic, political, and human rights crisis in the country. 30 years of neoliberal policies imposed by the international financial institutions have left the country with more social inequality, poverty, exploitation of women, and inflation. Protesters continue to take to the streets in spite of brutal repression and worsening conditions. Their brave mobilizations have been met with an outpouring of international solidarity, and many have called on institutions such as the OAS and the UN and countries such as the US and others to suspend their support for Moïse's dictatorship. Organizations across the world have called for an International Day of Solidarity with Haiti on March 29th to support the struggle of the Haitian people. March 29 marks the day the 1987 constitution came into effect. These organizations in the call include Alba Movimientos, the Desalines Brigade, Community Movement Builders, Code Pink, Organization of Human Rights and Democracy, Instituto Simon Bolivar, the International Week of Anti-Imperialist Struggle, Haitian Women for Haitian Refugees, Party for Socialism and Liberation, and Comuna Caribe. They have called on organizations to conduct rallies and symbolic and peaceful protests in US, Haitian embassies, headquarters of the UN and the OAS. They have called on people globally to take the issue to social media platforms with the hashtags No Dictatorship in Haiti, Down with US Imperialism, Long Live Haiti.